Please stand for a salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What is up, Comf? Today is Tuesday, May 12th, 2015. I'm Bailey Rosemeyer.
And I'm Ryan Patella, and it's time for KTV Live Innovations.
All right, I'm pretty pumped up for today's show.
I mean, didn't have a baseball game yesterday. That took away some of the fun. But we have a great show today.
So let's go. Today's KTV holiday is National Nurses Day. According to HolidayInsights.com, Dorothy Sutherland in 1953 proposed to the U.S. Department of Health to create a Nurses' Day. Her suggestion was accepted, and the holiday was made on this day in honor of Florence Nightingale's birthday. Make sure to appreciate all the things that nurses do to help you.
All NJHS members who cannot attend last week's meeting must see Ms. Casal.
Today's KTV birthday is Tony Hawk. According to FamousBirthdays.com, Tony Hawk is a professional skateboarder who started in the career at age 14. He continued on to become a skateboarding icon and released a popular video game series. Okay, that was a rough one. Tony Hawk will be turning 47 years old today.
Ms. Casal is a language arts teacher for sixth graders.
We are currently working on a persuasive writing unit, and also the students are practicing the skills and strategies that we learned all year through reading the Scope magazine and also applying them to the novel.
What are you doing with them next?
We're going to be really just finishing up on the persuasive writing unit and also finishing up with our novel.
What book are you currently reading with them, and what is it about?
The novel that we're currently reading is Down a Dark Hall by Lois Duncan, and it's a mystery. It's one of my favorite books to teach, and it's about a girl, Kit, who goes off to a boarding school known as Blackwood, and she has some very interesting experiences there.
What book did you most enjoy reading with your sixth graders?
Again, one of my favorite books to teach is Down a Dark Hall, although I really enjoyed reading Number of the Stars with my sixth graders.
She also states that one of her favorite things to do with her students is read the novels because it's a different experience with every class.
All right, Bobby. You know, my softball game was canceled yesterday due to the weather.
It was really bad.
I mean, I was here for fifth grade orientation, so I didn't get to watch any sports.
So hoping let's you get into in. Them. Last night in the MLB, Yankees beat Tampa Bay 11-5.
That's exciting, I guess.
Cubs, and then again in the MLB, the Cubs beat the Mets 4-3.
That is a close game.
Close game, I'm surprised.
Wow.
In the NBA, Golden State beat Memphis Grizzlies 104-84.
All right. I mean, so, that's, I
and
guess.
I think I that's all that we have.
That's so awesome. Great job.
All language arts classes read at least one book every year. Let's see what the next book Ms. Greenspan's 8th grade students will be reading.
What is the next book you will be reading?
The next book we are reading is Of Mice and Men by John Steinbeck. The two main characters are Lenny and George, and they are migrant workers who are currently living in California.
Of Mice and Men received a 3.8 out of 5 on Goodreads.com.
Manny's Diner is a quite popular place to eat in Clark.
The Clark firefighters were fast to respond to a kitchen fire on Monday night. The call was made to 911 at approximately 9:30. Firefighters rushed to the site, 1030 Raritan Road. Clark Police, EMS, and Union County Fire and Emergency Services were on the scene.
After the fire at Manny's Diner in Clark, I was very concerned to see if anyone was hurt, but thank gosh, no one was.
According to tapintoclark.com, the fire started behind the stove, traveled up the wall, and through the vent system. Sections on the roof were on fire, and the vent cap was melted into the roof, said Clark Fire Chief. The team put out the fire. The diner suffered mild damage, but no one was injured. Reporting for KTV, I'm Jillian Fiore.
Manny's Diner is still open despite the minor damage. All right, halfway through the show.
We got a break.
Friend.
Send it right over.
So, what's up, guys? We're here to tell you about some sports equipment. Rocky, do you have any gently used sports equipment just lying around that you don't know what to do with?
Yeah, I have tons. Like, all these years? Definitely.
Then you should bring it into school and drop it off in the box in the main foyer.
That sounds awesome. What are some acceptable items?
Some acceptable items would be gloves, bats, balls, and sports bags.
That's really cool. How about some unacceptable items?
We don't want any used clothes, used shoes, or used helmets.
Well, that sounds awesome. I'm definitely going to bring in the acceptable items.
All right, thank you. And I'd like to thank everyone else in the school for supporting this NJHS service project. So back to you guys in the studio.
Right.
I know I got a few old bats laying around.
Me too. I can definitely bring some.
Every baseball season I get hurt, so I got to have something.
All right. Well, on that note, let's get back to the news. The KTV Season 27 theme song was Radioactive by Imagine Dragons.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
Character in this video was Mary Kay Glacken, a former member of KTV from season 11.
Many people know General Grievous from Star Wars, but they don't know that he had a life before the war.
General Grievous, born as Kemen Jai Shalal, who was a master with a slug thrower rifle, and many thought he was a demigod because he was so powerful. He met a female named Kalish, whom he became very close with and renamed himself Grievous when she was killed. When his planet was attacked, he returned home only to have a bomb in his shuttle that nearly killed him, and only his torso, chest, and head were intact. Grievous was rebuilt as a cyborg by Count Dooku of the Sith and was promoted to general. He acquired his lightsabers from the Jedi that he killed. Reporting for KTV, I'm Luke Gilmer.
According to Eddie D of the Kumpf Infinity blog, Grievous fought his last battle against Obi-Wan Kenobi and was shot 5 times in the chest.
All right, Alyssa, so today I have shorts on and a t-shirt. I'm following dress code, though, I will say that.
Same with me. And there's a lot of humidity outside, so it's not the best for our hair. But let's just get into the weather. Okay, so today it will be partly sunny with a high of 90 degrees.
Ooh, that's really warm.
Pretty like warm. Summer. Tomorrow it will be windy with a high of 70.
Wow, that dropped pretty quickly, but all right.
Thursday it will be sunny with a high of 73 degrees.
Not bad.
It gets worse though. And Friday will be partly cloudy with a high of 75 degrees.
It gets worse. I think that's better if we want summer
to come.
I know,
but from 90 to 70s, not so good. Not so but I'm going to leave. Bye, Bailey.
Right, so Bailey.
I'm over here now. What's up?
So
do we have a preview? We have a preview tomorrow's show. So let's check it out.
Okay, so Gina, we are here with a preview of tomorrow's show. And tomorrow's show, it's jam-packed. One of the segments we have is an interview with a former KTV member, so that sounds pretty interesting.
We also have a segment on the captain of lacrosse, the Clark lacrosse team for Kumpf, so that seems pretty interesting.
So, you know, tomorrow's show, it sounds amazing, so let's pass it back to you guys in the studio.
Park lacrosse, other
lacrosse
stuff?
It ain't Kumpf flax, it ain't Kumpf nothing.
Okay, so on that note, for even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Ryan Patella and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm Bailey Rosemeyer. Have a fantastic day.